Good morning, everyone. This is Deb. This is going to be a little bit different. This is going to be a bead unboxing from a company called TheBeadCrate. And it comes like this from the big cheese at TheBeadCrate. And it's in Pinole, California, or Pinole, I don't know how you say it. Anyway, they have three different plans. I wrote it down here. They have the hobbyist, which is as low as $642 plus shipping and handling a month. It's a subscription service. The enthusiast, as low as $1,283 a month plus shipping and handling. Or the collector, as low as $31 a month plus shipping and handling included in that one. The other ones are extra for shipping and handling. That one is included. However, they also then have plans where you can sign up for 3 months, 6 months, or whatever, and sometimes the prices are discounted a little bit from that. So I get the collector. This is my fourth month in a six-month subscription. And unfortunately, I won't be continuing this after the 6 months is over, just because I have three bead subscriptions right now, and it's too much for me. So I had to pick one and stick with it, and this one didn't win because it's a little more expensive than one of the other ones I get that I like a lot. So anyway, here's how it comes. You get a founder's note, and then some paper shredded stuffy, and then there's always like a satiny or some kind of bag with all the goodies in it. But this gives you a little information about the kit. So it looks like this month the theme is purple passion. So we're, I guess, because February is amethyst is the birthstone. So anyway, and they do have a Pinterest bead crate, and I guess they have the theme purple passion. So they give hints sometimes on Pinterest and also on Facebook. And then the flip side of that, see, this says collector crate purple passion. It gives you everything you get by section A, B, C, D, and then everything will be in little baggies. And some things have an asterisk, which means it's a different amount for the collector's set. And sometimes it's a collector exclusive with two asterisks. And there it tells you the approximate retail value that per them of $57.32 for, we'll say, 31. I believe I pay 35, but I could be wrong about that. So anyway, with no further ado, let me take out that pretty purple bag and let's open it together. I have not opened this at all so far. I'm going to put everything down and then I'll just lift it up so you can see it. Very pretty. I love that bag. Beautiful. Okay, so selection A, it says, and see how it comes, everything's like this. Unfortunately, they don't actually print on the bag what it is as per this, which I would like because I end up having to do that. I actually have a jewelry business and I do use these items in my business, so I have to inventory all these things and write on them. But this is 3mm amethyst drukes, which is rounds, check glass. So tiny little 3mm amethyst beads, amethyst color beads, excuse me, in check glass. They do tend to have a lot of check glass. Okay, the next one is 11x16 tanzanite grape bunches, check. Oh, those are kind of cool. And you get 25 beads in the collector. I don't know how many you get in the smaller kits. Let me take them out. They look like this. Oh, those are kind of cool. Funky. Not sure how I'm going to use them, but I'll figure something out. Very funky. They are very dark, just like they're coming through, so they're a very dark grape. They'd make good wine if they were real, huh? Okay, selection C, where'd you go? Is 4mm tanzanite bicone machine cut check crystal 20 beads. And approximately 20 beads, it says. So these are bicones, which you cannot see. Hang on. I'm sorry. This is my first time doing a bead haul type thing for you all. And there, that's a little better. That's what they look like. They're pretty. So they're not Swarovski, they're Czech glass, but in my opinion, the Czech crystal is the next best thing over the, over the Swarovski. And I just dropped one. Oh, there it is. Sorry! Hope you're all doing well today. It is, I don't even know what time it is, early in the morning on Friday morning. And this is going to be another crafty day for me. Now, this is one thing I do like about this kit, is that they give you, sometimes, seed beads. The last few I've gotten have had seed beads. So these are Toho 8O Transparent Sugar Plum Japanese Glass. 18 grams, so that's a good substantial amount. Approximately 18 grams, it says. I don't remember that approximate sign being there before, but I do like 8O size because you can use it for a lot of things. Unfortunately, I'm not a real big purple fan, but I know a lot of people who are, and I do use purple. I just don't wear a lot of it. Anyway, yeah, 8O seed beads, Toho brand, which is a good brand. Okay, selection E is 5x7mm. Now, this is nice. Freshwater lavender pearls, and you get approximately 10 pearls, which looks to be exact to me. So, yeah, that's, they're actually very pretty, and I will definitely use those. Okay, F is Alexandrite Hearts Czech Glass, 25 beads, and I will definitely use those as well. They're hard to see. Let me take them out for you. Because I know from watching other videos, the plastic really glares, and I'm trying to get through this. Oh, they're on a string. Good. Okay, there we go. And please forgive my hands. Yesterday I was crafting all day, and I hot glued myself and instead of the paper, and yeah. So, and my nails, and I seem to have gotten, I don't know, black on my thumbnail, and my nails are a mess, and I broke a couple of them. So yeah, I'm a hot mess, which is why I won't put the camera on me while I'm crafting especially, and I'm getting ready to again. Okay, then another thing I do like about this crate is they often give you some kind of either silk or Nymo thread, or in this case it's silamide nylon thread, size A in lilac. And they give you 40 yards of it. That it's a true purple to me. It's coming through more blue, but it's actually a dark purple, like a grape color. Okay, H is amethyst flat squares. These are not two-hole. That's a pretty good image right there. Czech glass, approximately 25 pieces. So far, everything through section H is what you get in the other, oh no, that's not true. You would get it in the other smaller kits, however, A, B, and C are asterisks, which means you get a larger amount in the collector kit. Okay, so section I is 9mm amethyst flat pansy check glass, approximately 25 beads, and they're coming through pretty true to color. It's like a three-sided flower, but it's drilled through the side, not the center. Okay, so you could use them in a bracelet or earrings or whatever. And then J is 3x4mm clear AB faceted rondelles, Chinese glass. Let me take them out. Okay. I don't mind the rondelles in the Chinese, so they're very pretty and sparkly. I'm glad they're not the bicones, because I'm not real keen on the Chinese bicones. They're not cut. They sparkle, but they're not cut as well. Bear with me. There went one on the floor. Goodness. Sorry, guys. I have a very small space here to work, as I'm sure you who film all know. Okay, section K. 7x5mm Tanzanite gemstone donut check glass. So they're actually check glass. They are as dark as you're seeing. They almost look black. But they're supposed to be Tanzanite. Now Tanzanite to me is a lighter purple. So I don't know. This is dark like the grapes we saw earlier. Anyway, you get two strands. In the collector edition, you get two strands of 25 beads or 50 beads each. So that's a good amount. Okay, section L, 8mm amethyst diagonal cubes, check glass. Again, two strands of 25 each or 50 beads. And that color is coming through pretty true. Also, it's like a medium dark purple. I'm not sure how I'm going to use those. I've never used diagonally cut cubes. I like regular cubes. So yeah, that's a little different. I'll figure something out when I have time. Okay, selection M is 8mm amethyst faceted rounds check glass. Again, in the collector edition, you get two strands. These I like. 8mm is a good size. You can use with a lot of things. And they're faceted, which adds sparkle. I'm just not a big purple fan, but yeah, I'll use them. Now these, on the other hand, I actually love, because I think the color is more vibrant. They're 3x6mm Checkmates transparent bodacious bricks. They are definitely bodacious, and they are two-hole beads that I do like to use, sort of like a super duo, but they're like a half brick or a half teal. They're called bricks. They're a half tile in the Czech world, I guess is how you would say it. I love those, and I got about 50 beads. Okay, O is called... that looks brown, but they are actually more purple. I'll take them out in a minute. 6mm amethyst antique style octagons, check glass, 25 pieces. And these are only in the, as well as those bricks, are only in the collector. You don't get them in the smaller kits. Okay, I see what they are. They're more like a barrel bead with the ends. I don't know if you know those, cathedral beads. It's almost like a cathedral bead in amethyst purple. It's, the color is just not coming through, but it is a amethysty purple. Okay, that's that one. And a couple more. My crystals. Section P here is 4mm fire polish pastel lilac check glass, approximately 38 beads. Again, these are only in the collectors. These last four, starting with the bodacious bricks, are only in the collector, the largest collection. But those are really pretty. They're about the same color as those bodacious bricks. So yeah, loving those, and approximately 38 beads. And Q, I'm going to have to take out. These are 6mm amethyst. Again, they're really dark. Rondelle check glass, 200 beads, two strands. So it's a strand each at 100 beads. They're really dark purple. Really, really dark. I don't know. There are. Anyway, they're rondelles, which are smooth rondelles. Which you could use as spacer beads or stack them together. That's probably what I'll do, is stack them out there. You can see some of the color shining through. So they are deep purple, but they really are dark. Okay. That's it for my month of February bead crate. It's www.beadcrate.com, which is right there if you're interested. And the value that they put on here might be right, but it has to be full retail. And honestly, I get, when I buy beads, because I've bought so much in the past few years, I get good discounts at some online services, places, and so what I would pay for some of the same things, I can get at the discounted rates for about the price I'm paying for the kit. But if you are somebody that normally has to pay full retail, then this is definitely a good value for you. And if you like surprises in the mail, it's a lot of fun to open it and see, you know, something different, something you might not have picked, but it kind of forces you also to think outside the box to try and create. Now, one thing I'm not crazy about with the kit is you don't get any findings. So you don't get any spacer beads or charms or anything, any metal findings, basically. Chain. You do get the thread. You do get seed beads. So this is more of a seed beading crate. So if that's what you're into, this is a nice crate to get. And it is themed somewhat, but yeah, that's all I'll say. I can show you January and February because I haven't put them away yet, but I'll do that in a different video. Okay, we're at 17 and a half minutes almost, so I don't want to continue. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good day, and I should have another different bead crate, bead box, coming in shortly, probably in about 5 days. So I'll show you that one when it comes. Take care. Hugs. Bye.